गुड मॉर्निंग। ഫ്രൈഡേ ക്ലാസ്സിൽ സെക്കൻഡ് അവർ കഴിഞ്ഞതിന് ശേഷം നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഇൻട്രോ ഇല്ല കേട്ടോ, കണ്ടിന്യൂസ് ആണ്. സോ കൈൻഡ്ലി ബി ഇൻ ഓൺലൈൻ അറ്റ് ദ സെയിം ടൈം. ഓക്കെ രാഹുൽ രാജി, കൺവേ ടു അതേഴ്സ് ഓൾസോ ദാറ്റ് ദർ ഈസ് നോ ഇൻട്രോ ഫോർ ഫ്രൈഡേ. ഓക്കെ സോ ഷാൽ വി സ്റ്റാർട്ട്? Okay. Yeah, before that there are only three people, right? Okay. So, tell me the roll numbers. Roll number one. Okay, roll number one. Roll number one absent, two absent, three absent, four absent, five absent, six absent, seven absent, eight absent, nine absent, ten absent, 11 absent. Rahul Raju, can you hear? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Absent, 13 absent.
Sir, 12%, sir.
Okay, 13 absent, 14 absent, 15 absent, 16 absent, 17
17%.
Absent.
17%.
Okay, 18 absent, 19 absent, 20 absent.
Sir, roll number 3, sir.
ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ, നിങ്ങൾ ഇപ്പൊ വരണ്ട, നിങ്ങൾ ഇത്ര സമയം വേ വേർ യു അമിത്ത്. ഫസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ഓൾ യു ഹാവ് ടു ഗോ ത്രൂ ദ സിലബസ്, നോ ടൈം ടേബിൾ, ആൻഡ് യു ഹാവ് ടു നോ ദ ഹൗ വാട്ട് ഈസ് ദ ടൈം അലോട്ടഡ് ഫോർ ഈച്ച് ആൻഡ് ഈച്ച് സബ്ജെക്ട്. ഓക്കെ, ഐ കാൻ വെയിറ്റ് ഫോർ ദിസ് മച്ച് ടൈം, ഐ ആം വെയിറ്റിംഗ് ഫോർ ദ ലാസ്റ്റ് 10 മിനിറ്റ്സ് ഫോർ യു. It's not that much good. I said already, I told you, you have to be a good student. At least for, I told you that it is a problematic subject and there will be so many tutorial and everything. And the main thing is you have to be in time and you have to produce everything in timely manner. Okay. Pratyush.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we can start our class, or before that we can just go through the syllabus. We already discussed about it, but okay, can you see the screen right now?
Okay, sir.
Okay, fine. So this is our topics for the first module. Okay, so actually we discuss about the Rankine cycle yesterday, okay, and you have to understand what is steam engineering, and mainly we can divide this subject into three parts. Okay, first one is related with the cycles, or we can say simply as steam engineering, which includes the Rankine cycle and the modified Rankine cycle and few others also. Okay, then the next topic is on steam boilers. It was somewhat about the theory subject. Okay, the first topic based mainly have so many problems to solve. Okay, and from that module there will be questions also, and that topic there will be questions, and the second topic is steam boilers. In that they mainly discuss about the different types of boilers. Okay, mainly there is a few classification, mainly five classification, and there will be few boilers also, types of boilers, and we have to study the working and as well as the advantage and disadvantages of each boilers. Okay, after that we have to know what is there are some moldings and accessories. Okay, the boiler moldings and accessories, they are mainly because for the like free working or without for safety and other purpose we are using few devices, which is incorporated with the boiler, and that is known as mountings or boiler mountings. And there are so many accessories which can be integrated to the particular boiler at the time of working or the situation where it is working. And the last main topic, as I told, we can divide the three this module into three parts. And our last main topic is steam nozzles. Okay, and it is a theory as well as a problematic subject. Okay, problematic topic. Okay, we have to understand the types of nozzles, and a few derivations are there based on the velocity of the streams and a mass flow rate and a critical pressure, and it's significant. Here there is some from these three topics, there is some derivations as well as problem. Okay. And then the last two topic, the effect of the friction and the supersaturated flow, they're a little bit a theory, and you have to understand. So the main thing for this subject is you have to have a very good knowledge in your thermodynamics. It was in S4 last semester, there was a subject called thermodynamics. Okay, so we are taking some basic knowledge and basic application from that subject. So from the upcoming classes you have to know some basics. So for that I am saying that you have to go through the first two modules of the thermodynamics. Especially we have to give some attention on our steady flow energy equations and everything. It is in second module, I think. So the code for that is MET 202, I think, thermodynamics actually. Okay, so you have to go through that for the next week while we are having the class. I think the offline class is on the Tuesday, okay, for us. And I told for the every week weekdays there is thermal engineering class, so you have to keep your book. Actually, I told you we have to keep two books. One is for notebook and another one is for tutorial. Okay, this is a tutorial paper. You have to give, and you have better, you can keep the same for like a college note for tutorial also. Don't like, there is a short note, right? Having a 50 pages and like it's very half, very small in size. Don't use that. You can use a college one. Okay, I told you yesterday that you have to provide the steam table. Okay, you have to submit me the steam table on Tuesdays, yeah, before the class. I think for Tuesday it is in our class is scheduled in fourth hour, I think. So before that we have an interval at 10:30 or 10:20, I think, and at that time you have to provide. Okay, if you are not provided, then after this class I won't consider the attendance those who are not submitted it. Okay, so this is all about the introduction. Okay, so last day we can just discuss about the pattern also. Okay, and here the textbook is, you can just relay on this textbook. Can you see the highlighted one? Can you see that? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So I prefer this book, R.K. Rajapoot. Okay, you will get this book from your library. Okay, and most of the problem for your exam, I think it is coming from this test. So it is very good to have a book. Okay, and I prefer this one. Okay. So then after that, do you know how the pattern of your examination? Do you know? Hello?
No, sir.
Yeah, tell me. You know, right?
Yes, sir, part A, part B.
Okay, no, there consists of part A and B. Okay, part A and B. Your question paper, I can show you a model after discussing that. I will show you a model. Okay, so there will be mainly two parts, part A and B. And part A contains 10 questions, okay, which will contain 10 question, and in which two questions will be in each module. You have 5 modules, so from 5 modules there will be 2 questions each, okay, which consists of the part A, and which the mark for each question is 3 marks, okay. Then the okay, then the part 2 consists of 2 questions from each module, okay, and you have to answer any one of them, and you have to understand that the from part B, from the 2 questions there will be subdivisions also, there will be maximum of 2 subdivision also. So simply I can show you a model of the question paper which is provided in the syllabus itself, okay. Yeah, here is a model question paper. Yeah, look, okay, here it will be like here, in part A there will be 10 questions, okay, from, yeah, from each module. This is the topic from the first module actually, okay, from like this, there will be a 2 questions from each module consists of, and it will become 10, okay. Then part B will be like this, okay, there will be a question from 2 questions from one module, and maybe there will be a subdivisions, and the subdivisions may mainly will like maximum there will be only 2 subdivisions, okay. This is the pattern, okay, so we can start our class, okay. Okay. So yesterday we discussed, right, the thermodynamical. So yesterday we discussed the thermodynamical dynamic cycles, right, okay. So we classified into mainly 2, okay. What was this? First one was the heat engine, or what was that? Power cycle, okay. And the next one was heat pump or refrigeration cycle, okay. So first you have to understand that the heat engine, or we can call it as power cycles, okay, because they are giving us power, and this power cycle is again divided into 2. Vapor power cycle and gas power cycle, okay. This was the classification. So and after that we discuss about Rankine, okay, or a steam power plant, okay. For steam power plant, first one we start with what was that? A turbine, okay, a turbine, Here it is turbine, and this is condenser, this is feed pump, and this is boiler. Okay, so നമ്മൾ പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ടായിരുന്നു ഫോർ സെലക്ടിങ് എ സൈക്കിൾ ഓർ ഫസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ഓൾ ഇഫ് യു ആർ പ്ലാനിങ് ടു ഡിസൈൻ എ സിസ്റ്റം ഓർ എ പർട്ടിക്കുലർ തെർമൽ പവർ പ്ലാന്റ് സോ ഫസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ഓൾ വി ഹാവ് ടു അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ് വാട്ട് അവർ പ്രോസസ് ഈസ് ടു ബി കാരിഡ് ഔട്ട് അക്കോർഡിംഗ് ടു ദാറ്റ് പ്രോസസ് വി ഹാവ് ടു സെലക്ട് വാട്ട് സൈക്കിൾ വി ഹാവ് ടു സിംപ്ലി വി ക്യാൻ സേ ഫോർ ദ സ്റ്റീം പവർ പ്ലാന്റ് വി ആർ യൂസിംഗ് ഓർ വി ആർ ഫോളോയിങ് ദ റാങ്കിൻ സൈക്കിൾ ഓക്കെ ഇഫ് യു ആർ കൺസിഡറിങ് എ കാർ which use fuel as petrol, then it will be following Otto cycle, and for diesel vehicle it will be diesel cycle. Similarly, and for the like flights and everything, and there, so according to the particular applications, we have to select a particular motor process, as well as connecting to that we have to select the cycles. Okay, so you have to understand that here we are using for steam power plant we are using Rankine cycle. Okay, and I told you that we are considering cycles for the continuous. Okay, here what will be happening, whether the work will be converted into heat or the heat will be converted into work. Okay, for this there will be so many process, and okay, for that we have to consider a cyclic operation or a cyclic system. Okay, so if we are discussing about a process, okay, from one and this is two, okay, like this. Now maybe here the heating is happening, here it is like okay, here a process is happening. Okay, but for the continuous addition of heat energy, we have to consider, we have to consider a cycle. So first of all you have to understand first of all, we have to understand, as I told, this cycle can consider maybe the work is transferred into heat or the heat is transferred into work. Okay, so for this there will be so many process, and according to that process we will be selecting the cycle. Okay, this is the basic idea why we have to follow or we have to select a particular cycle for each process. Okay, so here we can discuss about the steam power plant. Okay, there will be a turbine, and there will be a condenser, and there will be a feed pump, and then boiler. So you have to, we can start from here. Okay, hello, hello.
Yes sir.
Okay, fine, fine. Okay, so here the so here the inlet of the turbine will getting a high pressure high temperature steam. Okay. High pressure, high temperature steam. Okay. So, and after the expansion, once here in the turbine, the expansion of the steam happens and the pressure will be dropping. Okay, the pressure will be, sorry, the pressure will be dropping. Okay, and it is converted into a low pressure steam. Okay, and from here it will be reaching at condenser, and from the condenser the latent heat of the steam or the change of phase taken place. Here the steam is converted into liquid, okay, by absorbing the latent heat. Okay, so you have to understand that the temperature will be constant here. Okay, sorry, 2 to 3, here the temperature will be constant. Okay, so here it was steam, and after the condenser it will become liquid. Okay, again, and from here you have to understand that here this is a low pressure, okay, and it is given to the inlet of the feed pump, where the pressure of the liquid, okay, here it was steam and it is converted into liquid, and this liquid, the pressure of the liquid is higher or get increased due to the feed pump. Okay, then it is given to the this high pressure. Okay, compare here, compared to here it is low temperature, right? And low temperature water is given to the boiler. Okay, so from the boiler what will be happen, the heat addition happen, and the change of phase, as well as the change of phase, the temperature increases as well as the change of phase occurs, and this liquid become what, steam. Okay, so this is the simply we can say this is the working of a steam power plant. Here we have to understand whether we are adding work or we are rejecting heat, and there are so many processes happening here. Sorry, just wait, okay. Okay, students, can you see now?
Sir.
Okay. Okay, fine. So here turbine, then condenser, feed pump, then boiler. Okay, so here what will be happening? Here the turbine will give work to us, right? Okay, we know that a turbine is a work producing device. Okay, so the turbine will be given work. So any one of you tell me here whether the heat addition or heat rejection happen. What will be happening here? It is a condenser. Okay, we already discussed it, so I am not writing. Okay, fine, I will write. Okay, so in the condenser, if you are considering a condenser, I am asking a question that whether heat addition or heat rejection, which will be happening? Tell me, anyone? Hello?
Rejection.
Heat rejection. Very good. Okay, so it will be like the condenser will be there will be coil. Okay, so just consider that the steam after the expansion. Okay, steam after expansion. Okay, will be reaching here, right? Okay, so if it is moving through the condenser, what will be happen here? The heat energy will be here. It is a coil. Okay, here it is a coil through which cold water, okay, will be circulating. Okay, so this cold water will be absorbing the heat energy from the steam. Okay, steam will be absorbing the heat energy from the steam. Okay, so here the temperature, here the phase change is happening. Okay, phase change is happening, that the steam is converted into water. So you have to understand that the heat energy which is absorbed by the water will be latent heat. Okay, so you have to understand that. So simply we can say that the temperature will be same. Okay, you have to know the sensible heating. Okay, then the latent heat already been discussed. Okay, if it is a 0 degree ice, okay, then it will be like sensible heating will be happening, then latent heat. Okay, then the phase change occurs, then again, okay, we can say from here. Okay, and it will be ending in the dry steam, or again if you are giving heat energy, it will become super heated steam. Okay, that we can discuss, already we discuss, and we can discuss it later. So you have to understand that here the change of phase of the working fluid occurs. Okay, this is one. Okay, this is two. This is three. So 2 to 3, we can discuss the process, what all the process is happening here. First of all, you have to understand what is happening to the working fluid. Okay, what is the change of phase of this? Okay, so then it will be become a liquid. Okay, it will become liquid. Okay. And this liquid is given to a feed pump. Okay, that liquid, or we can say it as water. This water is given into the feed pump. Feed pump. I'm just writing the short form. Okay, so here what will be happen? Here the pressure will be increasing. Okay, here the pressure will be increasing, or the pressure get increase. Okay, so. And the temperature will be remains constant. Here there will be little bit temperature drop, or the there will be a friction energy and everything. We are not considering it. Okay, while doing the problem, we can further discuss about that. Okay, so here the fan, and it will become a high pressure liquid. Okay, and this high pressure liquid is given to the boiler. Okay, so here boiler, now we are not discussing about how they are getting heat, or how they will be getting heat from the burning of the fluid and everything. So this is our next topic. Okay, different types of boilers, okay, and how they are working and everything. From that topic we can discuss how they are getting heat, or how they are giving heat and like converting the water into steam. There will be so many types of boilers and working. Similarly, there will be so many mountings also, mountings and accessories are there. Okay, this is our next upcoming. So now we are not discussing about that, how the boiler is changing or giving heat and changing the phase of the water. So again, here this water is get converted into steam, and that is given to the turbine. Okay, so we can, okay, so we told in turbine work is, so in condenser, okay, this is turbine and this is condenser. Condenser, the Q is rejected, right? So can you please say what will be happening in the feed pump? Feed pump, tell me, any one of you, tell me. Whether it is Q addition, or whether work is given, or work is obtained or rejected. Tell me.
Work in.
Work in. Yes, very good. Because we now need to discuss about the heat transfer, because there is no such process happening here. So, for working a pump, yeah, feed pump, we had to give work, right? So here we are giving work, okay, or we can say W in, or here it will be W out. Okay, so this is the thing. Okay, so here we are just feeding the working fluid into the boiler. Okay, so since we are using water, right? So this water, the working fluid given to the boiler inlet is also called as feeding water. Okay, so you have to remember this, because while doing the questions there will be a like the pressure of the feeding water is this much bar. Okay, so at that time you have to understand that this is the inlet pressure of the boiler. Okay, so remember this one. Okay, so the next one is that our last device is what? Boiler. Okay, so tell me whether the work is, or whether the addition of energy, what is happening? Tell me first. Hello? Hello?
Yes.
Hello? Do you understand the question? നിങ്ങളീ മൂന്ന് സിസ്റ്റത്തിനെ പറ്റിയിട്ടും നിങ്ങൾ പറഞ്ഞല്ലോ, പിന്നെ വൈ വൈ യു ആർ നോട്ട് സെയിങ് എനിത്തിങ് അബൌട്ട് ദ ബോയിലർ? യാ Heat?
Heat addition.
Yeah, heat addition. Yes, very good, very good, very good. Heat addition. Okay. You have to understand these all things are happening here. Okay. So, for the next class, you have to refer the steady flow energy equation. Okay. Refer yaan vecha, refer enna varanum. Okay. I will ask. So, each and everyone should refer this. Okay. If you are not having any note, you can just Google or refer with the help of any online media. Whatever it may be, you have to know what is steady flow energy equation. Okay, because for this all devices we will be applying this steady state equation and we will be obtaining the particular equation for work in tender pump and Q addition and Q rejection. For everyone, for every each things we will be getting a formula. For that you have to understand what is steady flow energy equation. Okay, so I am writing this also, steady flow energy equation. Okay, this is the thing. So for the next class, you have two work. Okay, first one is that you have to understand what is steady state flow, and the second one is that you have to write. We discuss about so many processes, right? Like isothermal, isobaric, adiabatic, isochoric, and isentropic. Okay, like that. So you have to understand and you have to write all the details of each process. Okay, simply we can say that for isothermal, we have the thermal. Yeah, the temperature is constant. Okay, then we can similarly we will understand isothermal, isobaric, isochoric. But for adiabatic or isentropic, what all things are, what all properties are constant? Okay, so you have to know this and you have to write and count. Do you understand? Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you have to show me the note. Okay, at that time, maybe if it is online, I will just tell all to just take a photo and mail me. Okay, so you have to complete that. Okay, so we can stop today. Before that, I have to say you something. The first thing is that wait. Yeah. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just 1 minute. Okay.